Hello students, so welcome to part 5 of the lecture series on previous year questions on the topic of sinusoidal steady state response. The lecture series is brought to you by EDAMIGO team. So we have already completed 4 parts of the lecture series. So let's start with the part 5. So this is a very simple question. So voltage VC across the capacitor is to be given and the units is in volts. Okay, so in volts we have to give the answer. Now this is the, it is given that it is 80 volts, it is 40 volts and this is question mark. 100 volts. Now, since we know that if current is at the real axis, for example, if current is at the real axis, if I assume current is at real axis, then the voltage across resistance will also be on the same axis. Okay, so this is 80 volts on the same axis as that of the current. Okay, so this is the current I am showing. So current is actually the current flowing in the loop. Now as we know that the voltage across inductance is j omega L times current, that is the voltage across inductance will lead the current by 90 degree. So this is 40 volts. Okay. So because voltage across any element is impedance multiplied by the current flowing through it. Right. Now voltage across capacitance is current multiplied by 1 upon j omega c, or I can say that minus j I multiplied by 1 upon omega c. So I can say that the voltage across capacitance will lag the current by 90 degree. Okay. Now the resultant will be, since VC and 40 volts are opposing each other, so the resultant will be 80 volts and the resultant here will be VC minus 40, assuming that VC is greater than 40. So that's why I have drawn the resultant as 90 degree lag with the current. Okay. So since I am assuming VC is greater than 40, that's why I have drawn this arrow downwards. Now the resultant magnitude of the resultant or the total voltage will be 80 square plus VC minus 40 whole square. So that will be the under root. That will be the magnitude of voltage. And as we know that the magnitude of the supply is given to us, that is 100. So that is equals to 100. So 80 square plus VC minus 40 whole square under root is equals to 100. So VC minus 40 is equals to 60 and VC is equals to 100. Okay. Okay. Now one important point here, it is that if we solve this, then the equation that we will get is this. Okay. Let me clarify this so that you have no doubts here. So VC minus 40 whole square is equals to 60 square will be the solution of the above equation. Now here, from here, we'll get VC minus 40 equals to plus 60, or it will be equals to minus 60. Okay, there are two options available. Now, since we have assumed that VC is greater than 40, so VC minus 40 will be positive only. So VC is equals to 100 will be the answer. So you cannot take the other one as the option. So VC equals to 100 is the right answer. Okay. So this is the solution to the problem. Now let's solve the another problem, a good problem. So here it is given that this is a circuit, and in the circuit shown, the average value of VAB in the steady state is the question mark. So VAB is this voltage, okay? A very simple question. Now, since there are two signals, there are two signals, 5 volt and this input. Now, since there are two signals, and this circuit has only resistance, inductance and capacitance, so this circuit is a linear circuit. So steady state voltage VAB will be equal to sum of steady state voltage VAB due to 5 volts and 5 pi sine 5000 t. Okay, so these are the two inputs. Okay, and for each input we will be finding out the steady state VAB voltage, and then at the end to find out the steady state voltage due to the two inputs combined will be equal to the sum of the steady state voltages due to the individual signal source. Okay, so now first of all, so I will draw the two circuits separately. So case one, when we are taking 5 pi sine 5000 t as input and 5 volt source is neglected, okay, so we neglect that or removed. So whenever a voltage source is removed, then it is actually short circuited. So the circuit will be like this. Okay, so circuit will be like this. Now we can see that the input is 5 pi sine omega t. Okay, now VAB voltage. Now since we have to find the VAB voltage and the polarity is plus here and minus here, so I can say that VAB is equals to minus times of 5 pi sine omega t multiplied by, okay, so let me first convert this into a phasor format. Okay, so let me first convert into phasor format. So let us take the input as 5 pi angle 0 degree. So 5 pi sine omega t is 5 pi angle 0 degree for me. 3 kilo ohms, okay, so I am combining these two. Capacitance 1 upon j omega c and inductance j omega l. So I am not putting the value of omega right now because I don't need that. Why? I am just telling you. So VAB will be equal to 5 pi angle 0 degree multiplied by, there will be a minus sign because the polarity is plus on the right and minus on the left. Okay. So by voltage division rule, the impedance of the capacitance divided by the total impedance. Okay. Now, after solving this, let us say that this whole term has a magnitude A and angle theta. Okay. So the VAB voltage in the phasor format will be 5 pi into A angle theta, because I am assuming that this term has A magnitude and theta angle. Okay. So I can say that VAB in time domain voltage will be minus 5 pi A sine omega t plus theta. Okay. Now, since it's a sinusoidal voltage, so the average value will be 0. So I can say that due to 5 pi sine omega t, the value of VAB will have a 0 average value. Okay, is it okay? Why? Because the VAB will also be a sinusoidal signal, and that's why average value is 0. Now, case 2. So here I short circuit the sinusoidal voltage . So this is a capacitance, this is inductance, and this is a resistance 2 kilo ohm and a battery of 5 volts. Okay. So I will add a page here. Okay. Now, since at steady state, the capacitance will be open circuited. Resistance is 1 kilo ohm. This is grounded. Inductance is short circuited. 2 kilo ohm resistance and a 5 volt battery. Now, since in this circuit there is no current, so current is equal to 0. So, and this is a 5 volt battery. So, to satisfy KVL, VAB value has to be equal to 5 volts. That is, the capacitance will get charged with 5 volts value. Okay. And since it is a constant value, so the average of this will be also equal to 5 volt. So now I can say that due to 5 volt battery, the average value of VAB is 5. Due to 5 pi sine omega t, the average value will be 0. So when both the signals are present, or both the sources are present, the average value adds up, and average value of VAB will remain 5 only. Okay, so this was a very good question, a conceptual question. Now, this is a theoretical question. Okay, so in series RLC circuit, we have to find the damping ratio. So this is R, L and C series circuit. Let us assume that there is some voltage source present here. Okay. Voltage source, voltage and phasor. Okay. So this will be J omega L. This will be 1 upon J omega C. So the current will be equal to voltage, or better will be, I write this in not in phasor format, rather in, so suppose this is VT. Okay, so now I convert this circuit into Laplace. So this is your IT. I convert this circuit into Laplace. So this is resistance. Laplace will be SL. This will be 1 upon SC R. And the voltage source will be Vs, and the current will be Is. Okay, so IS will be equals to VS divided by R plus SL plus 1 upon SC, that is equals to SC into VS divided by S square LC plus 1 plus RSC. Now, taking LC common from the denominator, we get IS is equals to VS, L will be common, S square plus R by LS plus 1 upon LC. Okay? Now, we have to find the damping ratio. Now, as we know that the format of the equation of second order circuits which has damping ratio as this is S square plus 2 omega n damping factor into S plus omega n square, or we use generally omega naught also. So by comparing the denominator with this, we can say that omega naught equals to 1 upon root LC and 2 omega naught damping factor equals to R by L. So damping factor equals to R by L 1 upon 2 omega naught. So that is equals to R by 2 L root LC, and this will be equal to R by 2 under root C by L. So this is the damping factor. Okay, so we can easily find the option, and we can see that the option C is the correct answer. So thank you guys, stay tuned, and we'll be solving more questions in the next part. Thank you.